Afternoon, bushcrafters, survivalists and preppers. Another bit about the weather I thought I'd share with you, because I get a lot of it. I'm outdoors all the time, so let's go and have a look. I was talking about weather, and I think I'll do this one on weather, because it's now pouring down. But I'll show you a clip I did before of a shower cloud moving in. And I was talking, as I said previous, that the clouds are very important to us, you know, in bushcraft, survival, or any outdoor situation. They have a basic understanding. This one was just another good example I thought I'd pass on to you. Anyway, let's go back to the clip.
This is what I mean about a cumulonimbus. It's a very high cloud, and as we can see, it's moving towards us. I'm going to watch it for a while. You can see it coming. We're blowing a northerly wind. It's already starting to spit here. You see it coming across the land, hopefully. Hopefully the resolution's good enough on this camera, but we'll just wait a bit. It's moving across over there. So if you see the difference in the green fields, where they're not so green is where the rain is. This very thick CB cloud. You can tell the darkness of the cloud. And over in the distance you can see some light cumulus clouds, which will be showery as well. But this one's creating a problem, and it's coming right our way. It might just miss us actually. So you can feel the spots of rain coming. In fact, I can hear them. Here they come. You see them hitting the window. In my last video I talked about the fun wind effect. Well, this is really what happens. And I mentioned, cumulonimbus clouds that sort of last 45 minutes. I'm not going to film the whole thing for you. But I just want you to see it. And it's actually covering quite a broad area. It might not be a CB, but it's certainly a heavy cloud or a formulating CB. It's a thick cumulus cloud. I can't see from down here. To say you can see them from a distance, if I look over to the coast of the UK, you can see the heights of clouds, but when you're in them and under them, here it comes. It's moving right across us now. Picking up on the wind. Now, if we're out in this, we could spot this one, but it was heavily overcast. We'd be thinking, is this rain ever going to go off? We'd be diving for shelter. We've gone to the crapper. We're thinking, oh no. It's moving in now. You can hear it. Sorry, I'm in the car, and that's where I'm going to stay till this is past. And as I said, you would die for some cover, and you'd hang on. You can see the sunshine coming in behind it, so we know it's passing, but it's obviously getting very thick over there. It's certainly fallen here. Here it comes. I find it incredible, the weather. Actually, the weather patterns. A bit like I find astronomy absolutely unbelievable. We're looking out at the Mull of Kintyre. We're on the Isle of Man. We're a far distance there across the Irish Sea. You can see the Mull of Kintyre. Or the Scottish coast, anyway. That old song, the Mull of Kintyre, oh, mist rolling in from. And this is the Mull of Kintyre, the rain's bloody hammering in from. Because that's where it's come from. See, now we're pretty well whited out with rain. It's like someone's put tracing paper over a picture, isn't it? And it's fallen heavy enough to bother us. We'd be wet, you know, and cold. It's very cold. 7°C. I know that's not cold for some of you, but it's cold for me. Well, in the middle of it now. See it coming down on the windows. I'd be extremely wet by now. Let me just... It's fair coming down. Note the cumulus clouds. The light, puffy, low-level clouds. Not the very high clouds, up to 20,000 feet. So you don't get any real weather after 20,000 feet. So I'm sure the people that climb Everest wouldn't agree there. But as a rule of thumb.
Yeah, it's passing over now. You see the cloud is tailing out up above there. We're now starting to get a bit of sunshine following, which is not always the case. But note how the tracing paper's getting taken off the greenery out there, that we can start to see the green again. That's an indicator of heavy rain if you're not already familiar with it. I know I'm talking to people here who experienced in this field, but it's just something I thought I'd share as a matter of interest with you on a Friday when things are calm. Meet the dog. One of them. Say hello, Odin. Odin. He's me ratter. There we are, pretty well gone now. Doesn't last long, usually, unless there's another one following on behind it. But look out for the tall ones. There's a few darker ones over there that aren't causing a problem. But when they get really thick, that's when you'd expect a shower. When they get into a cumulonimbus, that's when they really are going to give you very heavy but short period rain. When the cloud's full of these things, it could be raining all day, obviously, but just thought I'd share that.
Coming up next, how to get power from a spud. There's plenty of them about, guys. Light your tent.
Anyway, this is Pete at Pete's Place signing out, saying, please don't forget to subscribe.